put that thing away if you're ready.
Let's say it louder.
She says, there's a damn camera.
Go away.
Can we have a spoon for this? My just supposed to go like this.
For free?
I thought you said I was supposed to do that.
just before you had the muscle to hold it up for me. Exactly. I have a lot of room to talk, you know.
Shall we see what Kara eats?
It's on and stays on. You don't have to hold it.
Uh-huh.
Don't turn too fast.
See, there's some Reeboks on here.
What are we doing?
So just spend all your money? You waited home for a long time before anybody comes to me?
Not well, about 20 minutes.
Are we staying in HDR?
What a deal.
I stayed up all night last night.
You're catching some of the HDR.
Well, I think I got your best side, Larry. I don't know, I don't have wide angle lens.
Part of your best side.
Well, which one?
I bet it's Sarah. Sarah's the biggest child.
Carrie used to be funny. Oh, the world is so nice.
She has better things to do now.
You getting it all in there, writing, Millie?
Yes, it was. Yeah, I thought you were going to get dirty.
I ended up just laying down again.
It's a little dirty there, Sarah.
Hey, I'm not saying it's my brother.
That's hardly the criteria I choose.
I would be interested in knowing how Linda gets those socks white.
We may just throw those. No, we may let him use those for Little League catches. Yeah. They usually come back a little bit dirty.
Yeah.
Where? Where are they? Is your folks here?
Mm-hmm. They're bringing Grandma Hopplin.
Huh?
They're bringing Grandma Hopplin.
They're not sitting down yet.
They're sitting down.
Where's their chairs at, do you know?
Well, they get a picture when they get in here.
Well, were they coming in that way?
Are you going to stay with us, Kara?
Thank you.
class of 1989. As we gather here to honor these graduating seniors, we also honor their faculty members and other staff members who have worked for many years to bring these people to this day. During last year's commencement ceremonies, we gave special tribute by having the parents of the graduating seniors stand. I was reminded in a letter from Zula Reynolds of Newmarket that we also have many grandparents and great-grandparents, and perhaps great-great-grandparents that are here. So at this time, I would like to pay some special honor or make some special note of the fact that we have these people here. So if we have grandparents, great-grandparents, great-great-grandparents, would you please stand?
Thank you. each year during commencement. We recognize those seniors who have demonstrated academic excellence during their years of high school by compiling at least the average. Today, it's my privilege to present medals to those seniors graduating with honors, to present medallions to those seniors graduating with highest honors, to present trophies to the class valedictorian, salutatorian. Will the recipients please come forward at this time? Thank you. Kurt Levine. Lisa Richardson. Marlis Robert. Ernie Stephen. John Stoll. Carla Sump. Marcy Fummel. Chris Winter. John Wilson.
Thank you.
so many great times and fond memories. I guess what it all boils down to is what this diploma really means. Eventually, it will be a small token of our past, but yesterday is like a canceled text and we cannot negotiate again. This diploma will also represent one gigantic step into the future. Tomorrow is just like a commentary note. Unfortunately, it cannot be utilized until it arrives. Today, this diploma, we the class of 1989, are all about to receive, represents cash, and it must be invested into both future and present accounts. Even though the instruction may end in the classroom, education will end only with life. We are ready now to invest ourselves in the future. But by not knowing what the future holds, it forces us to live our lives one day at a time, step by step, and inch by inch. By doing this, we are guiding our lives in the direction of success. Success is a ladder that cannot be climbed with your hands in your pocket. Our hands were released when we entered grade school. And today, our class has reached just one great success in life. And we have proven ourselves to be winners. This proof is stated in the winner versus loser, which goes as follows. The winner is always part of the answer. The loser is always part of the problem. The winner always has a program. The loser always has an excuse. The winner says, let me do it for you. The loser says, that's not my job. The winner sees an answer for every problem. The loser sees a problem for every answer. The winner sees a greed near every sand trap. The loser sees two or three sand traps near every greed. The winner says it may be difficult, but it is possible. The loser says it may be possible, but it is too difficult. We, the class of 1989, have proven ourselves to be winners, and we will always strive for victory, because winners work at doing things the majority of the population are not willing to do. I wish to all my classmates and friends the very best of luck, and I hope that everyone here will always strive to be a winner.
Enable us to accomplish what we want in life. Never be afraid to learn. because learning is the key to our future. Thank you. As some of you know, I'm the last of my family's five children to graduate from Clarinda to high school. It is popular to say that the youngest in the family gets all of the attention. I want to tell you a little bit about getting the most attention. With my older brothers and sisters, I have attended four high school commencements, three college commencements, and two weddings. Now it is my turn for a high school commencement, and none of them are here. I'm still trying to figure out where all this extra attention is coming from. Each of these events has marked a change in my life. Each change has been more drastic than the previous one, and of course, this is the most drastic one yet. Change is not bad, it's just different. Sometimes I think our greatest fear is fear of the unknown. With myself, I've seen it time and time again. I'm not nervous about what I'm doing, but of the possible outcome of it. Change is scary because we're not sure what will happen next. Many times I have heard to have a positive mental attitude. This idea can get pretty aggravating after hearing it for a while, but it is a concept that works. Having a good positive mental attitude helps a lot when everything seems to come crashing down at once. We need to look past the problems and see the future in terms of the opportunities that are there, not the obstacles that might be in the way. We need to accept the challenges that come our way and even go looking for them. Challenges make us grow. They help us live to our full potential. Challenges make our lives interesting. Every now and then, we need a situation in which we feel the need to pull our hair out. A person who looks for challenges and accepts them is someone who's getting the most out of life. General George Patton said, "Accept the challenges so you may feel the exhilaration of victory." We are facing one of our biggest challenges right now. We are on the brink of adulthood, of being on our own. Our memories make us strong, and in some cases, provide an oasis from our problems. But don't dwell on them so much that it impedes reality. As Satchel Paige said, don't look back. There may be something gaining on it. This is totally off the subject, but I would like to read you a poem entitled "The Man in the Black." When you thought what you want in your struggle for life, and the world makes you king for a day, just go to the mirror and look at yourself and see what that man has to say. For it isn't your father or mother or wife whose judgment upon you must pass. The bellows' verdict counts most in your life is the one staring back from the glass. Some people might think you're a straight shooting chum and call you a wonderful guy, but the man in the glass says you're only a bum if you can't look him straight in the eye. He's the fellow to please, never mind all the rest, for he's with you clear to the end. And you pass your most dangerous test if the guy in the glass is your friend. You may fool the world down the pathway of years and get pats on the back if you pass, but your final reward will be heartache and tears if you've cheated the man in the glass. Farewell, 89 graduates. Good luck as you commence to do something different.
Graduation, please stand. Mr. Wickham, I hereby affirm that to the best of my knowledge, the candidates standing before me have met all requirements for graduation established by the Clarendon Community Board of Education and the Iowa State Department of Education. On that basis, and on behalf of the faculty, I present to you for graduation the class of 1989.
On behalf of the Clarendon School Board, I'd like to congratulate the class of 1989 and wish you the best. As you leave here today, I urge each of you to pursue one thing, self-esteem. You will find this by pursuing enjoyable careers, careers that will allow you to use your individual special talents to their fullest. Success is how you feel about yourself and cannot be measured by material possessions. Success is having high self-esteem. And now it's my pleasure to present you the class of 1989 with your diploma. Thank you.
Before we proceed with presentation of the diplomas, members of the audience are welcome to come out of the stage area to take pictures. Merrill Blair. Cassie Renee Paul. Tina Mae Gowdy. Heather Marie Greenwood. Angela Marie Howe. Teresa Sue Henry. Michaelina Ann Hyatt. Jennifer Ann Jennings. Christina Lee John. Jennifer Suzanne John. Juanita Laverne Kent. Holly Sue Cures. Jennifer Rebecca Lance. Carla K. Lee. Beatrice Leong Su Ni. Robin Kareem Martin. Lisa Marie Miner. Ian Gary Huff.
He went first after Freddie Stewart.
Danny Thomas Houston. Bradley Lynn Hughes. Jeffrey Ivan Hughes. Jason Lee Cooper. Darren Edward Leeson. Marshall Don Myers. Jody Ann Newman. Kendra Michelle Atkins. Rhonda Sue Osborne. Christina Marie Ostrander. Emily K. Poor. Doris K. Frank. Lisa Renee Richardson. Marlis Jean Roberts. Diane Stickler. Carla Jean Sun. Janine Jolene Swanson. Marcy Lynn Thomas.
I think it'll be all right.
Jenny was hollering. We went uptown and she had the camera. We had the radio.